Hi, everyone. Today, our topic will be SIP telephony and some basic scenarios. In the quantum introduction to SIP telephony topic, we discuss the underlying technology of SIP telephony, but in this section, we'll look at SIP telephony specifically integrating to an Avaya system. We'll go through the setup of a typical connection to an Avaya system and how it works with the QSIS core. In this particular case, we'll explore the methods for integrating the QSIS soft phone to an Avaya system. An Avaya system typically consists of two components, a session manager, or SM, and a communication manager, or CM. SIP endpoints register to the session manager, and the communication manager handles other functions, including communication to the larger PSTN network. We'll test this integration by making test calls to and from QSIS from a soft phone application running on a PC. Keep in mind that topology here is greatly simplified from an actual enterprise VoIP deployment, but the basic concepts shown here should apply to any running Avaya implementation. In your network, you may have additional devices like routers and firewalls and switches not pictured here. In this case, devices attempt to register to the session manager. It checks the credentials of each endpoint and responds accordingly. The endpoints can make calls when and only when they're registered with the session manager. There are two different methods required to interface QSIS to Avaya depending on the number of QSIS soft phones required in your project and your preferred setup. In this workshop, we're going to focus on soft phone registration. The scenarios described here are specific to Avaya. Other systems have different ways of handling these implementations and will be discussed in other trainings. The steps to configure an account in Avaya for the QSIS soft phone are as follows. First, we create a user profile that will be used for the soft phone. This will contain the authentication credentials. Next, we create a communication address that includes the extension and an optional domain. Third, we configure an application sequence that includes the session manager being used and specifying that SIP users will be using it. Last, we configure an endpoint profile, which assigns the extension to an endpoint and specifies items like the phone type. Let's look at each of these in detail. Navigate to Home, Users, User Management, Manage Users, and we see a few fields we need to configure. This configuration is automatically synchronized with Communication Manager. Let's see what needs to be in those fields for a new user profile. Fill in the fields on the previous screen as shown above to configure a new user profile. These credentials will be the ones we eventually use to configure the soft phone in Core Manager later. Click the Communication Profile tab, then click New to define a communication address for the new SIP user. After you click New, you'll see this screen. Select Avaya SIP as the type. This is the default as well. Then put in the extension number and SIP domain. Then click OK. Next, in the Session Manager Profile section, specify the session manager and assign the application sequence to both the originating sequence and termination sequence fields. Our last step is to configure an endpoint profile. For system, select the managed element corresponding to Communication Manager. For profile type, select Endpoint. Next is Use Existing Stations. If this field is not selected, the station will automatically be added in Communication Manager. For extension, enter the extension number of the SIP user. And for templates, select a template for the type of SIP phone. That's it on the Avaya side. Let's move on to the Core Manager side and see how things correspond to what we've done here. Now that the account is set up in Avaya, we turn our attention to the setup in QSIS Core Manager. First and foremost, we must confirm the core network configuration. We want to make sure the correct QSIS NIC is connected to the VoIP network and the correct IP address options are chosen. We spent a substantial amount of time on this in the networking sections of Quantum Training, so we'll trust that you know how to accomplish this. The next step is to confirm the shared settings for all soft phones. In this setup, we'll use LAN A as the VoIP interface. The SIP signaling port is set to 5060, which again is the default. This is the SIP signaling port for the core and is used for incoming calls to the core. The port used for outgoing calls to talk to Avaya is set later. SIP logging is enabled, which will be a useful troubleshooting tool if we run into any problems. And the rest of the shared settings we covered in quantum training before, but a quick refresh of the typical settings is shown here. SRTP is normally disabled. DTMF info is disabled as well. Avaya does not typically use that method. And the DTMF type is also fine for this application. Stun is also disabled. This applies mostly to hosted SIP solutions when the core is behind a firewall, which is not the case here. Now let's look at the individual softphone settings. The proxy field specifies the address of the Avaya Session Manager server. In some scenarios, a network can have more than one Avaya server. In redundant proxy applications, there's a backup proxy field to point to the secondary unit. By default, the proxy is using port 5060, but if you need a different port, you can append it to the proxy IP with a colon port number. In this case, we do want to register with the proxy. Most systems require this level of security, including this one. The transport setting selects the method of SIP communication required for Avaya. In this case, Avaya is set to UDP. We now move to the individual account settings we set in Avaya. The username field represents the extension number assigned in Avaya. These two fields must match, or we will not register. The authentication ID represents the login name in the Avaya setup that we configured earlier. In this case, it will match the extension, but it could be configured differently depending on how the Avaya side was configured. At this point, we should be able to go to our softphone block in our design and see the softphone successfully registered. If more than one extension is needed, go back and repeat the process for another softphone. And that's it for Avaya setup. In future sessions, we'll take a look at connecting to other types of systems and some further information on advanced SIP features on the core.